Hello, and welcome back for another Brain Coach Tip. I'm Jan Bedell, the Little Giant Steps Brain Coach. Thank you for joining me today to become more equipped to help your child be successful in school and in life. I do actually have a special guest today that I know you're going to enjoy. Now join me as I talk with Prisca of Cursive Logic. She and I will help you to understand the importance of being able to read and to write in cursive. If you're interested, the Cursive Logic books can be found on the Little Giant Steps store and at homeschool conventions at the Little Giant Steps booth.
So today, since we're talking about handwriting, I want to also include cursive, of course, because that's a very important aspect. And I have a special guest on today, Prisca. Welcome, Prisca.
Thank you. Good to be here.
Well, it's great to be here. I know that you are involved with a really fairly new product, but very exciting one, called Cursive Logic. And our listeners may not know much about this wonderful resource. So I just wanted to ask you a little bit about how long this has been around.
We have been on the market about 2 years. We went to press in April 2015. And since then, we've been through one revision of the workbook, and our new product, our gold standard product, is now available. It's been available for about 2 or 3 months, sort of brand new for the 2017 school year.
Tell me a little bit about how this concept or this strategy emerged for you.
Well, it's a really interesting story. So I am business partners with my mother, actually. Her name is Linda Shrewsbury, and she is the one that created the method. And it came about almost by accident, several years back. It's been a while. I can't remember the exact year, but she was working as a volunteer with a literacy program in our hometown, Tulsa, Oklahoma, and she was paired to a young man named Josh, who was 23 years old and had learning challenges. And he had basically made it all the way through high school without actually learning to read. So she was paired with him as a reading tutor, and they worked together for several months, and he made excellent progress, and she got him reading. And his goal in coming to that literacy program had been that he wanted to take the driving test. And in one of their sessions, he just confided in my mom that he didn't know how to sign his name and asked if she would be willing to teach him cursive because he really wanted to be able to sign his name. And she just thought that was such a touching request. She said, "Of course I will teach you cursive, of course." But as she thought about it, she thought, you know, at Josh's age, 23 years old, he just can't go back to the way grade school kids learn, just letter by letter, day after day, month after month. She thought he would become demoralized. And she just wanted to find a way to teach him cursive more quickly than that. So she went home, and my mom is kind of a state concept person. If you have these big sheets of dry erase paper kind of taped up around the house, she jots things down, and she wrote out the full lowercase alphabet on one of these sheets and just looked at it for a long time. And as she was looking at it, just a pattern jumped out to her that she hadn't seen before. She realized that although there are 26 individual letters, there are 4 shapes, and every single letter in the lowercase cursive alphabet starts with one of these 4 shapes. So she divided up the alphabet into these 4 shape groups. That was kind of the first inspiration. And then the second was that she connected them together into strings. So they weren't freestanding letters. They were 4 strings that kind of flow straight through, and all the letters in the strings share a common shape. So she thought, you know, I wonder if this is going to help Josh. And she thought maybe it would. She was a little excited, but she didn't necessarily have huge expectations. So she took this to the next session, showed the patterns to Josh, and he caught on to them immediately. In one session, he learned how to form every letter in the lowercase alphabet. And at that point, he was so excited that, you know, she taught him his uppercase initials, which were J and L. Right there, after 45 minutes, beginning of their session, he signed his name. And they were both just taken aback. They were shocked that he could have reached his goal in 45 minutes. Of course, he didn't master cursive that day. He was able to sign his name for the driving test. But fast forward to now, the young man has beautiful cursive handwriting. That just inspired my mom that maybe Josh's story could be the story of many other students, and she decided to turn it into a curriculum that could be made available to homeschoolers, to parents, and schools.
That's really exciting. I love that story. And when I saw you at a homeschool book fair, I immediately was drawn to your approach because it just it so amazingly just dovetails into our whole philosophy of learning anything, and that is that frequency, intensity, and duration. The frequency of doing those shapes that are the same over and over, and then just adding that little bit to make a different letter, I just thought was inspirational. My clients have loved it, and everybody that I've shown it to has loved it too. The way that it teaches the exception to the rules, they don't come down, like the O doesn't come down to the baseline. It dips down is what you call it. Those automatic things really what makes cursive very easy to do when it seems challenging sometimes for people with cursive, trying to learn cursive.
Right. We've seen wonderful results. We've seen kids that just were resistant to learning cursive, weren't able to master it, just pick up on it immediately. And they love tracing those fake strings. They're very sort of fun and rewarding to trace. Kids love it. I think our best feedback has come from the mothers of autistic boys. You know, they say, I just can't believe how much my son took to this. He loves it. And mothers of boys in general, because I think, you know, sometimes girls are willing to sit down and slog through because they want, you know, to have pretty handwriting and, you know, to do fancy handwriting. But, you know, boys usually don't take to it. But we just had mother after mother of boys say, it was unbelievable. My son just loved it. He loved it.
That's terrific. Well, I'm actually helping to homeschool my granddaughter, and she's 5, and she is on that first string of the over back trace, and she is doing fabulous with that at age 5. So I think for any age, whether you're wanting to improve your handwriting that you've already done, because they really are careful to help you make the letters correctly, because that's really important. Also, you know, just being able to write cursive, in my opinion, is important. One of the reasons is it's more efficient. When you're taking notes in high school and in college, it's just faster and more efficient to write in cursive. So that's one of the reasons. And Prisca, we've talked before about the importance of knowing how to read and write cursive. Do you have some tips that you want to share about that?
I think it's so important for every, you know, American person and people all over the world, but I'll focus on America for a moment, to be able to read cursive. And we've talked about this because of the historical documents that are written in cursive. And we used to always emphasize the Constitution, and a lot of people say that. How are students going to read the Constitution? You know, maybe we'll post this on Facebook. And someone will eventually point out, you know, one, who reads the Constitution anyway? And two, you know, isn't that available online in printed form? You know, does anyone really read it in cursive? And that's a good point. What I have realized over time, you know, I've had some chance to, you know, work with the National Archives, do some other various things. There are a lot of historical documents other than the Constitution that are written in cursive. Think about your family history for one, all the letters from your grandparents, you know, that they wrote to each other during the war. I mean, those are all going to be in cursive. But even our important historical documents, very recently Rosa Parks' personal collection has been made available to the public, I believe through the Smithsonian. It might be through the National Archives, but it's on loan for 10 years. And that just includes thousands of handwritten documents in cursive that haven't even been looked at by a historian before. You know, a student, a 7th, 8th grade student, could access one of those documents and write an original report that isn't just, you know, regurgitating a summary that somebody else has already written about the historical figure. They could do some original research if they read cursive. And I just think that's so important for every student to be able to operate on that level.
I agree that not just the Constitution, but all those documents that they wrote, Federalist Papers, and all of those personal letters that they wrote to each other that state who they were and what they believed, all of that is so important. So cursive is important in a number of areas. And we also have some research that someone has quoted, says it's neurologically so important for boys, and usually about the 8 to 10 year old level. So that neurological connection that's different between boys and girls, it seems to really help with that as well.
One of the main reasons that we do try to emphasize cursive is because of cursive's effect on brain development. And there has been a lot of research that has looked at various aspects of this. One observation that I think really drives the point home is that sometimes stroke victims will lose the ability to read either print or cursive, but not the other. And that just shows that it's different parts of the brain that are affected by these different functions. There's a neuroscientist that we've interacted with a bit named Dr. William Clem out of Texas A&M, and he emphasizes that the effect of reading and writing pseudo letters instead of traditional letters impacts the brain very beneficially. And what I mean by a pseudo letter is that the cursive letters are less standard than print letters. There's just more to them, and people's writing of them varies more. So to learn to read cursive, you have to be able to match, you know, a variety of different B's that different individuals might write with the concept of B. That impacts the brain positively. It's kind of like, you know, when they say elderly people should do Sudokus to keep their brain active. Well, reading and writing cursive serves a similar function, keeping the brain active.
That's very interesting. The brain is an amazing tool, that's for sure. So if you're interested in looking at the cursive logic, we have this on our sponsor, littlegiantsteps.com. You can go there, just type in this, and that will come up. Well, there's one other resource that you might want to mention, Prisca, I am intending to use for my granddaughter, and that is the posters. Tell us a little bit about that and how that could help with especially children with learning challenges possibly, or younger.
Yes. So as we've already talked about, in cursive logic, there are four basic shapes, and then there are four letter strings associated with each shape. So students learn by first tracing each of the basic shapes, and they'll make it six times for some of the groups and eight for one of the groups that has eight letters, and then they trace a string that has the letters, six letters or eight letter strings. And in the workbook, there's fingers tracing, which is about an inch and a half tall, and then there's writing with your pencil, which is, you know, about half an inch tall. But we've also developed a product with a large poster that makes it 6 or 8 inches tall. And students trace those, putting the ball, a tennis ball, or, you know, a squishy squash ball or something in their hand, and it allows them to learn the strokes with gross motor motion. So this can be really helpful to young children, the fine motor skills for writing. It's also helpful for children who are struggling with any kind of learning disability that makes it, you know, hard for them to hold that pencil and focus on something small. It's just another way to build muscle memory. It's also just kind of attractive and interesting to the kids, and it's fun to hold that tennis ball and trace while you say the chant. We haven't talked much about the chant. To the shapes and strings, there's an associated chant while chanting. This really helps build muscle memory. And that's really the core of cursive logic, is building muscle memory that allows the students to execute those letters perfectly every time without having to think so hard. And how do I make a cursive B? You know, that's really going to be in their brain and it's going to be in their arm, the way the cursive logic practice progresses.
Now, that's part of that frequency, intensity, and duration, that going over and over, building that muscle memory. Because with the cursive logic, they see actually a specific color. They hear it as they're saying it. They see it, and they write it. So we're involving all of the channels of input to the brain with this product. I really appreciate you being here with us and letting us know about this wonderful resource.
Thank you so much, Jan.
I always enjoy learning new things from people in different aspects of education. Thanks for joining us for this cursive writing discussion. I hope you've learned something new today, too. Oh, and just as a reminder, consider the metabolic consultation, where you can get additional individualized help for those health challenges that oftentimes arise. Go to littlegiantsteps.com and click on Metabolic Consultations on the homepage. This will start the process of scheduling a free metabolic consult. For your neurodevelopmental questions, call Little Giant Steps at 972-758-1260. That's 972-758-1260. That's all the time I have for today. I hope that I have assisted you in your journey toward understanding other aspects of homeschool, like the importance of cursive writing. Please tell a friend about the knowledge you're gaining here, and stay tuned to the braincoachtips.com, where you will receive more brain-enhancing tips to make life and learning easier. For now, it's the Brain Coach signing off.